Alright, so another day, another golf video. That means that more parts have arrived. I'm still yet to do my oil change, but what you're seeing right here are things that I've just acquired that are ready to go on the golf. Well, at least this side is. So, this is a dash camera. This is the VFO A119 V3. This is the dash camera that I've run in all of my cars. This, of course, is going in the Golf. However, I'm waiting for a 12-volt switch I ordered to come in for the main parking mode wire because I want to be able to switch parking mode off because 99% of the time I don't need it. Whilst I do want parking mode 99% of the time, it's going to be in the garage at home, being that this is a project car and not a daily driver. So I'm waiting for that before the dash cam goes in. We have a cabin air filter, which I'm going to show you how to install, which is going to go just right about here, which I'm excited to get in because the design on these cars, I feel like in heavy rain, the cabin filter gets wet, and when the aircon goes on, the car actually smells pretty bad. So I've got a feeling the cabin filter might have a bit of a smell to it, and that might help improve the interior cabin smell a lot. And in this parcel here, we have Canvas T10 red bulbs, and that's to go in the third brake light. The only reason I want to do this is two out of the five bulbs in the reverse light at the moment they're not blown, but they're a little bit out of the ordinary in that they warm up and cool down slower than the other three bulbs. I'll show you that now. So as you can see, they're a bit out of the ordinary. Plus, I think for brake lights, you want them to come on instantly instead of having a warm-up time. So of course, LEDs, you know what I'm like, I love and obsess over LEDs. So we're gonna be putting super bright LED brake lights into the third brake light, and that's pretty much it for today. So let's get started on installing the cabin filter in the car. So ignore my extremely dirty engine bay, but up the top here, there is 1, 2, 3 fasteners that need to be removed. And then this piece of plastic here can be awkwardly removed from the car, and that will reveal the cabin filter. So on the right here, we have our old dirty cabin filter. Mind you, this one has already been vacuumed out and tried to be cleaned up. As you can see, it's very, very gross. And I think this is gonna be the source of the smell in my AC. So we're gonna replace it with a brand new one, which is hopefully gonna make a big difference. So all you do, slide it back into this plate, and we'll chuck this back in the car. And there we have it, fresh cabin filter installed. And there we have it, a fresh cabin filter is installed on the Golf. Let's move on to that third brake light now and improve those globes. So to replace the third brake light on these is super simple. Open the boot up and here is the third brake light. On the side there is a little button, so press that on both sides and the cover simply slides off. So here we have the piece. I've just cleaned out all the inside to make it nice and clean. There are our 5 T10 bulbs and here are our LED replacements that we're about to put in, and let's have a look and see what the difference is like. So there we have the third brake light done with all of the LED bulbs in it. I want to put this all back together now and see how much brighter it is. All right, so everything's all buttoned up now and you can hardly tell that those LEDs are in there. It is absolutely awesome. So I'll put the camera on the ground again, press the brake light, and we'll see this difference. Watch the fact that there's no warm-up time and they are super bright in comparison to the bulbs in the taillights. Alright, so I would consider that a successful mod for the Golf. It's definitely brighter and they warm up and cool down so much quicker. They're instant on and off compared to those taillight bulbs, which are soon to be replaced with very similar LEDs. And the cabin filter has improved the smell of the inside of the car. But with that being said, that's just another quick video with some of the stuff going on with the Golf. I'm just documenting literally everything I do to this car so you can see it and watch it back yourself. Hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have, make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And with that being said, I'll catch you guys in the next golf video.